Ancient Egypt is our people. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad said the tribe of Shabazz. So, what you find in Bible, what you find in Holy Quran is history, but only a very small part of it is history. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad says 75% of the Bible is prophecy. Then what is prophecy? The Honorable Elijah Muhammad taught us that in the Bible, in the book of Revelations, it mentions 24 men who are called elders. These men, he said, are absolutely gods. They have extraordinary power over the forces of nature. They have wisdom. But one from among those 24 is called the Supreme One. He is the ruler over the circle of the 24 elders, and he is the one that they call the Supreme Being. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
The Honorable Elijah Muhammad said, when the wickedness of a civilization reaches its apex, that one from among the 24 would be commissioned to go down into the general public of the people and find one from among those people who is prepared to deliver a message. They would then, at the time, receive the message in what are called visions or dreams. Or the scientist or God would speak to them in their ear, telepathically. Y'all don't hear me. Are y'all with me? Is everybody okay?
Yes, sir.
Y'all sure y'all interested in this stuff?
Yes, sir.
We can close out now. I don't want to bore you, you know. So, let me get to this presentation. So, that one would receive the wisdom, that one would be called a messenger, or a prophet, or a warner. He would add revelation or wisdom that he and the people have never heard. And that wisdom, because it's new knowledge, knowledge beyond the general public, gave that warner or prophet and the people that he came to the advantage. That advantage is the opportunity to escape the chastisement of God. This is not the first time that it's happened, but this is the last. As the minister said to us one day, he said, this is the end of the end. If you don't believe it, study more. If we don't believe it, study more so that we can see that there's a need for us to change. You see? So, these prophets, warners, messengers, all of them were sent to a people. And all of them received books or wisdom that came in their ear, much of which was compiled in books by those whom they taught. You see? Likewise with the Holy Quran, likewise with the Bible. The Caucasian knows, and they'll tell you in a minute, the theologians, that the Bible is bad history. They don't know how to reconcile what they think is history in the Bible because it doesn't make sense. But the Honorable Elijah Muhammad said it is absolutely prophecy. So it was given to those who are written in these books. Some of them are actual people, Paul being one. Others are not actual people, but they represent people in the future tense. But they were written about thousands of years ago. This is heavy stuff, and I don't have enough time to go into that. Now, in the future tense, there's always someone that represents what those in the past have spoke of, have sown, had envisioned, or have dreamt. Paul was a man like that, but he was not a Caucasian. In all of the pictures and depictions of Paul, you find him depicted as a Caucasian. All of the pictures and depictions of Jesus, you find him as a Caucasian. Most as a Caucasian. The white man has turned the black prophets and messengers into white people and have given them back to us as white people because these black men came to them. They didn't come to us. You don't find prophets in Africa. You see? Now you might read about it in the book of Exodus where Moses was in Egypt, but that is not the truth of the matter historically. In the caves and hillsides of Europe. What is in Egypt that is written in the Bible is a prophecy that is making specific mention of today. So this man, Paul, was an actual human being. He was formerly named Saul, and was one of the most important apostles of Jesus. Not among the 12 disciples or the 12 apostles. Historically, they did not exist. But he did. There was no Matthew. There was no Mark. There was no Luke. There was no John, who were disciples around this man called Jesus in the Bible. Jesus did not have people like that around him that taught. And the scholars and theologians know it. But this one, Paul, was a disciple of Jesus. But he had an experience that represents something that the minister would experience hundreds and hundreds of years later. Of the apostolic age, of that time of apostles, he was known as the most important. And he was a persecutor of the Christians until his conversion to Christianity. Paul, in his travels through Rome, he was a Jew, they said, who lived in Rome. He spoke multiple languages. But the original Jews are black people, not white people.
That's right.
And he persecuted the Christians. He gave them, as we would say, excuse my language, hell. Now, 13 of the 27 books of the New Testament are specifically attributed to the writings of Paul. Seven of them, they can authenticate. 11, some say 11, they can authenticate. But 13 of the books are attributed specifically to Paul. Some say 11, some say 7. They can prove and authenticate. Who came and gave Paul wisdom. And that this is in the book of Acts chapter 9. He gave Paul wisdom that removed the scales from his eyes. See, it was something Paul couldn't see. But if you follow me, I'm not talking about history. I'm talking about prophecy. I'm talking about what happened to Minister Farrakhan in 1977 in Hollywood, California. It wasn't until 1980 that the minister came to see Elijah Muhammad as alive. So Paul's experience that was documented thousands of years ago represents something that would happen today. How many of us read the Bible, the Holy Quran, and it's just amazing how the Bible and Holy Quran parallels almost perfectly what we're experiencing today. That's just about everybody here. That means there's something in these books that are extremely relevant to what we're doing, but the question is, how did it get here? Now I have friends who are in the quote-unquote conscious community, black conscious community, and they follow different schools of thought. They don't want nothing to do with the Bible because they say it's the white man's book. They don't want nothing to do with the Quran because they say it's the pale Arab's book. Unfortunately, they don't know enough about prophecy or revelation and how it comes and who it comes from and who it comes to and why to even have a legitimate, intelligent discussion. So Paul says that in his experience, he has his vision of this one that he thinks is Jesus. This one named Ananias helped him to see that this one or this experience was actually Christ himself. Now, this is another experience, 2 Corinthians 12, that I'm going to read. I'm only going to read from 1 to 4. I'm not going to read from 4 to 10. He said, it is not expedient for me doubtless to glory. I will come to visions and revelations of the Lord. I knew a man in Christ above 14 years ago. Whether in the body I cannot tell, whether out of the body I cannot tell, but God knows. One, such a one brought up in the third heavens. And I knew such a man. Whether in the body, I cannot tell. Whether out of the body, I cannot tell. How that he was caught up into paradise and heard unspeakable words, which is not lawful for any man to utter. So several things. What is 14 years? How was he caught up into heaven? The third heaven. What does he mean, in or out of the body? I did not know. And what did he hear that was inexpressible, that no one was permitted to tell? All of this is wrapped up in something that had taken place September 17, 1985. Now, Paul was a type of Minister Farrakhan, and his experience or vision was something that was real for Farrakhan in the future tense. Are you all following me? The black prophet or the black apostle Paul. Now, there's a term called typology. And I've gone over this before, but a type are two objects, objects, actions, or concepts that have a specific feature in